Hey guys, James here today, and welcome to something a little bit different for the channel, at least for the time being. I guess it's a little bit different. Back in the day, I did used to do this, although I don't think there's any other Sims 2 house building videos on this channel. There used to be, but that was a long time ago. Anyways, here we are in The Sims 2 doing a house build, which, I mean, might seem a little bit odd. But as you guys know, I do a Let's Play in The Sims 2, The Sims 2 Robot Factory, which is a lot of fun. So I'm still playing Sims 2 at this time. So it's not just like I just randomly out of the blue decided to build. I was playing the game. And, you know, it has been a long time since I've ever built something in The Sims 2. The last time I built something, I guess, properly, like, not in a Let's Play, properly, I guess it would have been, well, Sims 3 came out 2009, so I guess anywhere around there. Probably 2009, I guess, was the last Sims 2 build I did. But I don't know. So it was a fun little throwback to go with that. Is it Thursday? I don't think so. I think it's Saturday. So this is not Throwback Thursday. This is sit back Saturday. I don't know. So anyways, we're in Tweaky Island at the moment, which is the world that came in Bon Voyage, or one of the worlds that came in Bon Voyage, one of the vacation worlds where your Sims can go on vacation. So this is a vacation home that you can buy, but of course you can, I mean, I guess you could just place this in any neighborhood. As long as you can place a beach lot, then that'll work. So you've got the beach right on your doorstep. It's a very large sort of home, very large, very modern, you know, kind of nice. It ends up being kind of a fairly large home with a lot of unusable space. I guess you'll see what I mean in a bit. I mean, you might be able to tell a little bit from the thumbnail, but not much. So at the moment, I'm working on the roof, doing a little bit of constrained floor elevation. Yes, that existed in Sims 2. So Sims 2, in case you're wondering, came out in 2004. And pretty much build mode was almost identical in The Sims 3. I mean, there was obviously a few changes in Sims 3. Namely, I guess, the creator style tool, which added all the sort of coloring and that kind of stuff. And then, I guess, the terrain, obviously, the terrain in Sims 3 was much smoother, I guess. But most of the stuff in The Sims 3, like the cheats, like move objects, constrain floor elevation, snapping of objects, rotation and all that kind of stuff, it was pretty much in Sims 2. So I guess that's why when Sims 3 did come out, I was already been building in Sims 2 for a long time. So, you know, the skills pretty much transferred over. Whereas Sims 4, it's pretty different. And I definitely noticed this while building this house here. I was going to say, it definitely does take longer to build in Sims 2 and also Sims 3. But then I can also put down it taking longer in Sims 2 due to the fact that I haven't played it for building purposes in a long time. So, I spend a long time just going through items in the catalog trying to find stuff. Because, you know, I can't remember what's in the game, so I'm just kind of just picking stuff out, going through. And, of course, there's the whole issue of colors and trying to get things to match nicely and that kind of stuff. So I spent a lot of time on those kind of aspects. But in Sims 4, it definitely is a quicker experience to sort of build in because of, like, the whole room system. And it just really actually does make it a lot quicker, which is interesting. But then I guess we don't have the advanced sort of constrained floor elevation in Sims 4 or... I guess we don't have any terrain in Sims 4 for that matter either. It's all just flat. So he is hoping those things make a return. But going for these awesome sort of two-story windows here. Oh yeah, by the way, this was built in with all expansion packs, obviously, with Sims 2 Ultimate Collection that was on Origin. So yeah. Don't know where I'm going to post the download for this. I mean, the link will be in the description, but at this point in time, I don't know where it will be for download. Probably just off like Google Drive or something. I don't know, but yeah. In case you're at all interested in downloading it, I don't know. Either way, even if nobody downloads, I thought it'd still be a fun video to do and sort of a nice thing to sort of look back at and see how far we've come in terms of, you know, The Sims, I guess. Yeah, just picking some colors. So the exterior, as we saw, was sort of like a black and white kind of color. Color scheme that we got going on. I try to make the inside a little bit more colorful when we get to the actual furnishing and interior, but that won't be for a little while because this is quite a long video. I don't think I've done a house building video this long for a while, actually. I don't even know because I remember because the Sim Supply channel, that we're on now and that you're all subscribed to watching this video on was actually, this was made in 2009, this channel. But then we had a channel before this that had Sims 2 house buildings on it. And I don't know how many, I think we had like six or so of them. But I mean, that channel doesn't exist anymore. I don't think it does. Or it doesn't have any videos on it anymore. I don't know. Going on a complete tangent, I'm going to look it up. Let's see. Because I remember I retrieved the password for it a while ago. And then I think I was able to log back into it. There's some videos on there. Let's see if there's any house building videos on there. Oh, there totally is. Look at that. Not all of them are mine, though. There's house building, Sims 2 house building, episode 6. Oh, that's actually Sims 2 building homes, episode 6. Then 7, then 8. I think those three are mine, and then the rest are other people's. That's pretty cool. Look, the Sims 2 home, the Sims 2 building homes episode 6 has 11,000 views. That's a pretty good video. How many subscribers does this channel have? 89. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I definitely did log into this because it has a link to, it says new channel and it links to the Sim Supply. So definitely did log into that. I was thinking of doing a sort of throwback to that video, maybe post-commentate, like commentating it, because that didn't have any commentary back in those days. That was posted 6 years ago. 6 years ago, guys. That's crazy. This is definitely Sit Back Saturday right here. Let's see when it was actually posted. July 18, 2008. Wow. That was a long time ago. I even posted a comment on that video 11 months ago myself. there's quite a lot of comments on there, 43. I don't know. You guys can't see any of this. I will probably link to the video or something. Or maybe I'll probably do a video of this, actually. Like, just repost a video but commentate over it for a little bit of fun. That's kind of funny, though. That it's there. The quality is awful, though. Because this is 2008, mind you. What do we got? 360p is as good as it is. that's pretty good. It's even got a little watermark on the video and everything. Look at that. Oh, wow, I'm good. Anyways, I'm going to stop watching another video while I'm going to be... I'm, like, watching another video while you're watching this video. Okay, sorry. Yeah, that's... I was getting a little bit nostalgic there. Where are we up to? So I wanted to build a really big balcony out the back here, but I didn't realize that you couldn't build over the beach. Like, with that flat part of the beach, it doesn't let you build over it at all. I totally forgot that was a thing. So the balcony sort of just ends up not being as big. Well, the deck doesn't end up being quite as big. This part here, actually, that just started now, is actually, I live streamed this morning for about 2 hours. I was live streaming over on Twitch, just having a chat, chill out session. You can, if you really want to watch this sort of stream of this, which is, I guess, going to be the same thing as this, but in real time, you can go to my Twitch page, which is linked in the description, and go to past broadcasts, and you can see it there. It'll be like Sims 2 house building or something like that. It's like a 2 hour stream. This house build in total took about 4 hours, like everything. So like two of the hours I didn't stream, but then two I did. Because I definitely wanted to get the build done today so I could post it today. So I thought, you know, streaming makes me productive. So let's go stream it. So there was also quite a few good suggestions here and there. Also, if I guess pause anywhere or just start doing weird things, it's probably because I'm explaining something or showing something to people. I don't know. Because I think I was... the streaming is productive and also counterproductive at the same time. Because, you know, it gets me working, but then it also gets me chatting and reading the chat. So here's where I was trying to work out the upstairs layout. Because it's if you hadn't noticed, it's a fairly odd-shaped house. I think it turned... I'm pretty happy with how I actually furnished it in the end. Given sort of the items and floor plan available... I think it turned out pretty well. So here I was trying to figure out where I wanted the hallway to go. And doing it like that left two weird shaped bathrooms. Like two square wide bathrooms. In the end, I did actually go with that. So it just kind of worked out like that. Oh yeah, I was going to do a bowling alley in there. Just for a little bit of a laugh. didn't end up happening. Took up too much room. So we're just going around finishing off the windows and all that kind of stuff. I'll tell you what, though, you do miss a lot of the features of the newer Sims. Like, even features in Sims 3 I was missing, like, you know, placing items anywhere off-grid. There is a cheat to do that, but then a lot of the items sort of glitch out and don't work properly when they're placed off-grid. And the whole rotation thing in Sims 3 as well, because in Sims 2, you can't rotate items diagonally without a cheat. I mean, I used a cheat to rotate it, but And that you can't do full 360 degree rotation like in Sims 3 and 4, so that's kind of annoying. There's a lot of little things like that that you sort of miss and, you know, you take for granted. But there's definitely a lot of fun sort of coming back here. So I was working out what floorboards I wanted there because I didn't really like any of them. Ended up with those ones. So here's where I'm sort of, this is where it begins. This is where I begin just going through the catalog, trying to figure out what colors and objects and kind of stuff I want. So the next, I guess, 20 minutes of this video are furnishing, basically, because that's how long it took just to sort of regain my, understanding of the game. Because I guess, like I said, building isn't really that different. It hasn't changed that much. I guess Sims 4 is the biggest change to building since Sims 2. So, because obviously Sims 1 and Sims 2 are very different. But you still build in the fundamental same way in 1 and 2 and 3. So then when 4 came along and mixed it up, I mean, fundamentally, they're pretty similar in the way you build, but they introduce all the sort of new tools as well in Sims 4, so it does make it very different, and it does actually make it a lot faster to do certain things. So begins the, trying to choose objects. I had to just settle on a counter. I didn't really want those ones, but I think in the end, I'm actually very happy with the kitchen. I think the kitchen took me somewhat to like 20 to 30 minutes by itself, just trying to figure out what I wanted to do. So now, you might be wondering what I'm doing here and why there's a big pole there. That column is there because on the level above, there's a room there. And there's also a balcony. So if that column wasn't there, it would kind of look like the room above is kind of floating. So I put a column there. And the reason I put an archway and a fridge there is, well, firstly, I wanted to put a fridge in that spot because it looks kind of cool. And secondly, you put the sort of doorframe arch. And I did this in Sims 3, I think, as well. I haven't done it in Sims 4 yet, I don't think. But you put the archway in that wall and then the fridge, because when they open the fridge, the archway will allow, you know, you to see the inside of the fridge. Otherwise, there'd be just a wall there and it would look kind of glitchy and weird. So the little archway sort of just cuts out a hole that you can see in the fridge with. Of course, shelves are the future, so they make a comeback and a snowman. I was really excited when I found shelves in this game. I was like, oh my god, I couldn't remember if they had proper shelves or not, and they did. And I was like, oh, this is awesome. So shelves make it into the house. They are futuristic indeed. And they also had range hoods. I was so excited about that. There were so many items I was just like really excited about. Like if you do ever go back and watch the stream or something, or even just listen to the stream or something, you'll hear me just being so excited with some items. I'm just like, oh my god. Oh, by the way, if you're watching this and you are good at making, or you know how to make custom items in The Sims 4, can I please request that you or someone converts almost every Sims 2 painting into Sims 4? Because some of the paintings, by the way, are so awesome in The Sims 2. They're really colorful and really nice. And it would just be a lot more options in Sims 4 then. You'll see some of them when I use them. And there's just so many good pictures in The Sims 2. I forgot, like they're so good. I would love to see them in Sims 4. So get on that, all you object modders out there. Also, I guess while you're at it, you might as well convert all the Sims 3 ones as well. While you're at it. I don't know, or at least not all of them. It doesn't have to be all of them, but there's some really nice ones, though, that I would love to see again. Oh, there's that zebra pattern or picture from, that's an IKEA picture. If you've ever been to IKEA, you'll see that zebra. Yeah, look at those pictures. They're so nice. And then there's this really colorful tropical bird one as well. Which I presume came with Bon Voyage or something, I don't know. You'll see it in a minute. That one. Oh, that's so nice. I love this really little picture of the birds. It's so good. So good. I don't know. I was just really, this is the point where I was just like, oh my god, the paintings are so good. So working on the dining area. The dining, basically it was going to be kitchen on the left there, dining in the middle, and then living on the right side of the screen now, or the bottom, or the right again, depending which way we're facing. I moved over the sort of little archway into the rear section of the house because I wanted the dining table there and it was kind of in the way. Because otherwise the dining table is sitting in the middle of a hallway, so I kind of adjusted it a little bit. It also, that sort of back room, by the way, is going to be like a rumpus room area. So, you know, this is the living, dining, kitchen area, and that's the sort of recreation area, that next room over. Because I guess this room is good because it's the entertaining area, and it opens out onto the balcony at the back as well. So it's quite nice. So here's where I was struggling with rugs. Rugs are not very good in this game at all, because you can't place them off-grid. You can't place them on quarter tiles. So it becomes really annoying trying to get a rug that, first of all, looks good and fits the area. which is extremely hard, by the way. But the genius that my mind is managed to do it. No, I just sort of settled on a rug, and that that light wouldn't go in the middle. Then I used the snap. Yeah, this is where you can the snap on, snap off is a shortcut cheat I also made in Sims 2 that allows you to place objects anywhere. And now I'm using columns here to sort of act as like a kind of little archway sort of thing. But then someone pointed out in the live stream chat I could have just used a door archway. The initial reason I wasn't going to use an archway there was because the actual gap where the archway was supposed to go was supposed to be 3 squares wide. And there's no 3-square door arch in The Sims 2. So I was like, oh, I could just use columns. That will look really good. And then I forgot I moved the archway and made it smaller. So I could have just used a regular one. But I was like, well, I've already done this. So I'm just going to leave it because it looks kind of good anyway. So I ended up using columns. So I was trying to figure out how to do the best layout for the living area here because it's kind of an awkward place. You got these large stairs there and then you have the walkway. It's kind of like the sitting room sitting in a walkway area that goes out onto a balcony. So what I did instead, I flipped it the other way, had the sofa under the stairs. And then TV on the other wall. I didn't do the TV under the stairs because, and I explained this on the stream as well, was because the stairs are 2 squares wide, putting the TV under there, it would have to be either really far back under the stairs or really far forward, and it just wouldn't look right. It would look like a really sort of empty space. So instead what I did is I had the sofa, you saw it, the sofa was a little further forward, it wasn't on the wall, and then I sort of put shelves and bookcases behind the sofa, so it looks kind of good. So here's where I'm messing around with the TV area, the little entertainment section, and I get a pretty brilliant idea, if I do say so myself. I mean, it's a little bit arrogant, but just wait till it happens and you'll be like, oh my god. No, anyways. So I was trying to figure out, because I wanted to do something underneath the TV, because it looked really blank. Like, as you can see, just without anything, it just looked really bad. So here I also found that a double shelf existed, and I was like, oh my god, there's double shelves. So what I was doing here is I was moving the shelf back so it lined up with those two red shelves either side because they only come out a little bit. But of course it came out of the wall, so what I did was put like hedges and plants on the other side. So it does actually stick outside of the wall on the back, but you can't see it because there's hedges there. Like, hello, genius. Oh, anyways, I thought it was a pretty good solution to the problem because it allowed me to do those shelves sort of flush in line with those two red CD book tower kind of things. I don't think it looks pretty good in the end because you'll see me putting it in there. It lines up with it quite nicely, actually, and I was quite happy with that. But yeah, I thought that turned up pretty well. Pretty good idea, if I do say so myself. Don't know why I'm talking like this. What? I don't know. Just talking like this. Imagine if I spoke like this in every video. Hey guys, Flabber Leaky here today. Oh, wait, Flabber Leaky's on the other channel. Whenever I do a stupid voice, I always do it as, hey guys, Flabber Leaky for some reason. I don't know. If you don't know, I have another channel. I do, you can check it out in the description down below. And I do not talk like this on the other channel. Playing around with ceiling tiles. I don't know if I actually changed it at all. I think I was just messing around a little bit. Oh, there's a star ceiling as well. That was kind of cool. But yeah, you can see the living space and dining area is looking quite nice. I'm quite happy with it, actually. Thanks to the live stream chat as well that provided sort of helpful feedback during the process. So I get a couple of pot plants there, like I said, and I put some bookshelves behind the sofa. Those ones are a little too tall, so I get some smaller ones instead. And I think it actually works quite nicely in that little space. It adds a little bit of detail, and it means it's... It means that space, I mean, the space is technically wasted, but, you know, it adds a little bit of detail and sort of fills it in a little bit. Doing a couple of ceiling lights in the that area there. So moving on to the rumpus room area, going to have a beautiful large pool table here. And then there's the downstairs bathroom. Oh, yeah, this house ends up being 4 bedroom, 3 bathrooms, I think. Yeah, there's 1 ensuite, 1 bathroom upstairs. And 1 downstairs. Oh, I added in a sauna as well, because that was a perfect spot for it. I was like, I don't know what to do in this area, because it was only 3 wide. Then I found the sauna. I was like, oh my god, that works like perfectly. Perfect little fit of a sauna in there. This was kind of nearing the end of the live stream. I was really struggling to sort of come up with ideas. I always find, and if you guys find it as well, like whenever you're building in, you know, whatever Sims game, or I guess any game in general, whenever you're sort of creating something, and you just hit like a point where you're just like... I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. It's just not working. It's always best to just take a break and come back later. And then you'll be like, oh yeah, I got an idea. I can do this. That's generally what I do. Like this particular build I started last week, I think. And I was just building on and off, working away at it. Then I decided today was the day. Today was the day it was going to be done. It was actually going to be yesterday, but then I didn't get it done. So I made it today instead. But yes. Yeah, this is the point in which I was pretty much degrading my thought process and I couldn't figure out what I wanted to do with the room because there's a little bit of extra space there. People suggested putting in the sort of arcade machines and that kind of stuff, which is a good idea because that is like a rumpus room area and this is a, like a holiday home. So I guess putting in that kind of stuff makes sense in a way. And that's what I did. Don't know why I spoke like that either. Sorry about that. I apologize. So that is the end of the live stream there. And now here we are back onto me just building and listening to podcasts, adding in some funky patterns. I don't know. That kind of just added an interesting pattern to it. So I chucked that in. Kind of looked cool. Added in the zebra pattern right there on the wall. I don't know why I keep calling it a pattern. The zebra picture, which is an actual IKEA photo if you've ever seen the one at IKEA. It's totally there as well. If you live near an IKEA, if you've ever been to one, you will have seen that zebra picture. It's pretty cool. I think The Sims 2 IKEA stuff is my favorite ever, like, I guess, little stuff pack in any Sims game. Because it just adds so many, like, realistic items. And items that actually look good as well. You know, they're real. They look good for The Sims. It's just awesome. I think I used so many of IKEA items in this build as well. They're so good. Anyways, moving on to the downstairs bathroom, just a sort of, I guess, contemporary kind of feel to it. Nothing too special, just, you know, tub and bath. I don't know why I said tub and bath, it's the same thing. Bath, sink and toilet. Sitting on a toilet. Sitting on a toilet. Sitting on a toilet and flush. You'll see me doing it there. I moved the shower into the actual wall there so I could have the wall tiles inside the shower. Because I thought it looked a little bit better. Hopefully they can actually use that. Did not test that, but I don't know. I mean, I don't think it will affect that many of you because I don't think that many of you are actually going to download this. But if you do, and you're still listening at this point as well, if you do download it, let me know in the comments because it'll be actually intriguing to see how many people actually still, first of all, still play Sims 2 and still download it. It'll be interesting. Getting the nice bland wallpaper happening upstairs. That does change. I usually just use one floor flooring and wallpaper to sort of coat an entire section, and then I go through and customize it bit by bit. But yeah, so we're doing that now. Getting some lights upstairs, making sure it's all lit up quite nicely. I do also have a test sim that is actually that actually owns this house at the moment. You can see them outside very briefly. I was testing a few things out with them, like specifically like the fridge. I was making sure that worked and all that kind of stuff. So it was handy to have them there. So that is the master bedroom there, the little ensuite. Yeah, like I said, the bathrooms are an interesting shape. What is that, 2x5 by the looks of it, the size of the bathroom? I spent so long picking a color for that bed. And then I spent ages here as well trying to use carpet as like a rug. And I could not get a single flooring that looked any good. I was trying to make it, I don't know, I just couldn't get it what I wanted it to be. I really liked that navy blue color that was briefly on the walls there, but it didn't go with the room. So it sort of went with like an earthy toned brown and bluey? I don't know. Is that what I leave it as? I don't know if it changed it anymore. I guess it's like, that's not even a blue, it's more of a teal. Like a light teal and I guess a dark brown by the looks of it is what I've gone. Or is that black? Maybe it's black. Can't tell. Can't tell from the little video preview I'm looking in. It's either dark. No, I think that's black. Or it's really, really dark brown. I don't know. Anyways, yeah, in the end, I changed the carpet underneath the bed just to a rug. I'm pretty sure that's an IKEA bed and IKEA end tables as well. So there you go. And that's an IKEA sofa. Like I said, I use a lot of IKEA furniture in this build because it's awesome. I wish it was another IKEA pack. So good. So they have a double built-in wardrobe with mirrors. So, you know, that's pretty luxurious right there. They don't have a walk-in robe, though. Not enough room for that. That was a weird little nook, that corner there. Don't know if I actually ever did anything in that corner now that I think about it. I don't know. I can't remember if I put anything in the corner or not. Anyway, got a little sort of vanity desk stand thing there. I don't know what they're called. It has a name, and I can't remember what it's called. Just copying the sort of bathroom design, putting it upstairs here into the ensuite, which is a beautiful four-piece bathroom, sink, toilet, shower, and bathtub. It all fits in there. Oh, yes, it all fits. Getting some towels. I was surprised how many little decorative objects there actually are to put on walls, like in the bathroom. No toilet paper, though, which is sad. So, might be able to use toilet paper. anyways, just adjusting the layout here so that they could use everything in a nice manner. A little plant. Did I put that there or not? I changed it to that one. Oh. I was trying to do some hallway furniture here. I did not like it at all. I couldn't find a nice place to put anything. So in the end, I just deleted it. I moved on to the next room. I was going to do like a desk there, but I was like, the desk, putting in that there just completely intrudes on the whole, like the chair is in the middle of the hallway. It's just not good. So I was like, nope. There was nowhere else to put it either that would make any sense. I was like, oh, in the middle of the hallway, that makes more sense. Moving on to the bedrooms, the other two bedrooms. Well, actually, there's three other bedrooms, but we're working on two of them now. Trying to choose a bed. Got a matching bed to the master bedroom. That's the same bed, but like in a single form. Of course, it is an IKEA bed as well. I spent so long picking bedspreads, actually. Well, not the second one, on the first one I did. Doesn't look very long in 7x speed, though, which we're running right now. Getting a few colourful bedrooms here, just to mix it up a little bit. Light peach sort of colour. This is the nursery! Yeah, we're revisiting the nursery, if you saw my Sims 4 nursery build. It makes so much more sense in Sims 2 as well, because there's actually nursery items, like a crib and a changing table. Also, the curtain choices in Sims 2 are absolutely awful. There is no modern curtain or no just clean basic curtain. That was the only thing that I had, like that really fancy one that would fit those windows properly. And I was like, most of the rooms in this house don't have curtains, by the way. But I was like, those curtains, I guess they're fine for this particular room. It's a nursery. And like I said, I was surprised by the number of decorative items in this game that actually like fit and made sense in the room. So we got, oh yeah, you saw that IKEA chair as well I put in there next to the bookcase. Oh, that's awesome that they have that. I wanted a nice rug in the middle, but there was nothing I could put there. It was sad. I'll tell you, we are in the other bathroom now, the other 2x5 bathroom. Not ideal bathroom sizes, but they kind of had to be that way because the hallway in the middle is 3 wide that runs in the middle there. So it kind of had to be. Otherwise, I would not be a happy man, unfortunately. Anyways, more towels and just decorative items. So these bedrooms, I guess the bedrooms are fairly basic. I didn't really know what to put in the bedrooms. And to be honest, they're a really awkward shape of bedroom. They are really awkward shape. It was hard to furnish them as it was. And then I was trying to add in built-in wardrobes as well. And that became incredibly difficult. But you'll see me sort of fumbling around within a minute as I do it. So I wanted to put them both in the middle there because it made sense. One on either side. But then that door, you couldn't put a wardrobe next to a door. Even with move objects on, it didn't really work. So then I was trying to figure out another way that I could fit the wardrobes there, move the doors, but I couldn't move the doors and I couldn't put the wardrobes there, so I gave up on that. Then I was trying to find a nice, like, just freestanding one. None of them are nice. Let me tell you that now. Not a single one I enjoyed, nor fit the room at all. In any sense that I enjoyed. Then I gave up and tried to do built-in again. So I did one built-in there, and then the other one only had the choice of going there. So that, again, creates incredibly weird-shaped rooms, which I guess is a little bit of a lack of foresight on my part for... Because like you know, and like you always see in these videos, I always build the exterior first. I never design the exterior around how I want the interior to be. Unless I have a specific vision for the interior, which I usually don't. Usually I just build the outside first and I build what looks good. But that can often end up in the floor plan not working particularly well, as is the case of this build with two 5x2 bathrooms and two incredibly, terribly shaped bedrooms. I mean, they're really, really something else. I mean, they still have everything in them, but they're not a great shape. And I guess if I had planned a little bit more around the floor plan, I could have avoided those bathroom problems. And bathrooms aren't really a problem; they're just not ideal. I could have avoided the bathroom shapes and those bedroom shapes as well. But at this point, I was too far into the build to sort of reconsider the shape of the house. It was just not really possible without changing a lot of stuff. And the thing is, something like that in Sims 4, and that's I guess that's why Sims 4 is a little bit quicker in places. Like, that in the Sims 4, changing a fundamental part of the house is pretty easy in the Sims 4, really. You just click and drag and move it around. So here's a little seating area out the balcony overlooking the indoor, I guess, conservatory area. Filled with tropical plants. I thought I made this area like a little indoor gym area as well. So it's kind of like a little sitting area, entertaining area. I guess you could sit and read there, just enjoy it. It'd be nice. You have a lot of sun coming in there. It'd probably be like a little bit of a greenhouse as well with all those windows. And then I put those couple of exercising machines around there. So on the top level, just doing a single table. I mean, the outdoor furniture is pretty basic in this because I don't know. I didn't really know what to do in Sims 2. It took me ages just picking a chair to use as well. So I just do a single, like, large table on the top here. Pretty basic. And then I do another table and barbecue on the lower level. Table on a pot. There you go. So down here I do the other thing. Also, actually, I added a lot of plants at the end because I thought it would look really nice. But then I started getting a really bad frame rate. So I don't think adding a lot of plants is a good idea. I did remove some, but it's still a little bit laggy. So if you do download this and you are still listening and it's a little bit laggy, just try removing some of the plants because there are a lot of plants. And you'll see, I think I'm doing it now, where I go around to spam plants everywhere. I don't know, I thought it was going to look nice. And I guess that's why not a lot of the houses in Sims 2, like in the pre-built houses, have a lot of plants, because the game doesn't like it particularly well. I mean, I guess you probably won't notice it in this video at all because it's sped up so much, but it was a little bit choppy when I was playing it, which is unfortunate, because I wanted it to be like super lush. I wanted to create like a really tropical sort of jungly vibe around the house, but I had to limit it to literally just around the house, and I also had to remove some stuff. Ideally, I would have liked to have added a lot more. Having some beach soccer, and then I was just playing, I wasn't going to actually do a basketball court, but I was like, oh, hang on, I could make that. That looks kind of cool. Put that in my mind for future reference. Yeah, this is where I'm removing a lot of those things because it was lagging a little bit. Just doing a little bit of terrain painting, not too much. And then we'll jump into these screenshots in just a moment. And we'll go through, go around the exterior of the house and then go inside and have a nice little look at it all. And nice high detail screenshots. And here we are jumping into the screenshots here. Obviously starting around the front, you can see the front of the house here. Beautiful entrance, so lush. Look at the garden. I wish I could have done more with it, but oh well. So the outside is fairly sort of, I guess, modern and I guess a little bit, I don't know, I can't think of the word. Bulky. large. Anyways, yeah, so it's fairly like modern and I guess I don't know, I can't think of the other word. But there it is. That's what it looks like. I thought it was a fun sort of design. Something a little bit crazy, I guess. Just simple black and white color scheme on the end, or outside. There's the entrance there, we're walking in. We can see the lower level of the conservatory here. That's as far as you can zoom out. The Sims 2 camera doesn't let you zoom out very far. That's the entrance into the main house area, which I thought looked really nice through those windows, actually. Here's the dining and kitchen area. Oh, I think this turned out really well. Like, when I actually went to take these screenshots and look at it from a ground level, I thought it looked so nice. I'm really honestly happy how this turned out. I was kind of skeptical that it could be anything good in The Sims 2. After being so spoiled from like The Sims 3 and all the customization in that, and then the new game of The Sims 4, I was worried going back to Sims 2, I'd just be like, oh, this looks, ugh. But I'm genuinely surprised at that it turned out, you know, half decent. But yeah, there it is. So here's the downstairs bathroom with beautiful curtains, orange curtains, that half of them don't fit the windows at all. Here's the upstairs landing with the stairs there on the right, and a nice large rug down the hallway there. Here's the workout area, the top level of the conservatory with the little sitting area as well. Another little angle of it there, so you can see all the trees and plants. Just a nice little area to sit and relax. Here's the nursery. I wish you could zoom out more, but you really can't. there's another angle over there. A really nice little detailed room there, actually. Again, I was surprised with the items that were there. Here's the master bedroom. I guess fairly uninspired. I think the bedrooms looks kind of lacked a little bit. I didn't know what to do with them. I didn't know where to find items for them. I don't know. I couldn't really... the angles of these rooms as well, that's the best I could get. But yeah, download link is in the description down below, guys. Tell me what you thought of the video, if you enjoyed it at all. But anyways, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you next time, and have an awesome day.